Now we're getting to one of the three episodes that actually involve Molly just trying to get along with her life while also exposing the fact that people think that she actually killed Hannah Montana. In this episode, Kissing Goodbye shows an example. Since that everyone finally knows that Miley Stewart was Hannah Montana the entire time, people are going to trash her because Hannah Montana, to some people, was weird to them. And then when the sequel was revealed, people think that Miley completely killed Hannah Montana. And it really goes to show because in the beginning of this episode, after the sequel was revealed, she completely is over with the Hannah situation after going back and forth with the double life and stuff. And since that Miley is able to be part of the college that Lily's attending to, things are starting to turn out really easily. However, people will easily still trash her since that she was the one that killed Hannah Montana. I mean, after going through so many interviews and so many conversations with people that Miley, while dressed up as Hannah, completely communicate over some occasions over the years, you can tell that they probably have the same reaction once she revealed the Hannah Montana secret. And I have to admit, that's probably something that people will probably get themselves into when they reveal the secret eventually. Especially since that Miley was probably like about 6 years since she was wearing the Hannah gimmick in this timeline or something. They would easily see that Hannah Montana was real, a real fictional thing that actually happens in reality in the Hannah Montana universe. Believe me. I can guarantee you if someone would probably do the same thing of what Miley's doing right now, I guarantee you that it will probably be the same thing that will happen in reality. And this is an episode when Aunt Dolly steps in just to help her cousin Miley, just to help out all her situation that she's dealing with. She needs to discuss that Miley needs to go on stage and to show everyone the world that she still got it, even though that she exposes the secret. And I will admit, that's probably something that I actually kind of enjoy with the moral of what this episode has to offer. Because Miley has this imagination and a vision that she will remain in her bedroom for the rest of her life, with cats around her. Because she really, really, really is miserable with her life, with so many fans hating her constantly. And that's probably the biggest roadblock on Miley's situation when it comes to going with Lily to college. I guess it really goes to show that she really, really wants to have a normal life, just like her double life when it comes to her Miley Stewart high school life. And it really makes this probably one of the most hilarious scenes in this show, because it really goes to show that Miley is doing a midlife crisis, that she has to show the world that she still got it without the Hannah Montana wig. And there was another subplot involving Rico and Jackson. However, it's just basically about the reveal of Hannah Montana, and Rico is acting completely stupid. Yeah. This episode actually shows that Rico made a fool out of himself, that he didn't actually see Hannah Montana as Miley Stewart, while Lily as being Lola. And you know what? Considering the fact that people don't take the wig seriously in this universe, this is when I decide to give up on the wig ideal, because at this point, the wig ideal just isn't a big issue when it comes to how people are acting in this. Besides, I think the only reason why Miley's secret kept a secret after all this time is because of the different clothes that she wears. And the fact that Miley Stewart in high school just isn't a sinner in everyone else's eyes. So for this subplot alone, Rico just loses against Jackson, just kind of like Hannah's gonna get this episode. Except that it's probably the most infamous because, well, Rico just made a fool of himself. Yeah. So we lost to Jackson again because he made a fool out of himself. In other words, don't ever think ahead on your intelligence. That's a lesson to anyone who is like Rico. I really enjoy Kiss the Lock Goodbye because of the ending and the effort that they did, which involves the ending. Because when the end came, when Miley Stewart completely sang Kiss It Goodbye, which is one of my favorite songs, I think it really goes to show that she got what it takes to show the world that she still got it without the hand of Wick. And the fact that the situation that he's been through throughout the entire episode, I guess this episode is basically a perfect example of how without Hannah Montana, Miley Stewart is still a celebrity. And I really think that for the final episodes of this show in general, it's probably one of the best since that the Hannah wig is completely gone. And now Miley is just trying to focus on either going with Lily to college, which is the dream she wants to go to, or go do a movie with Tom Cruise, which the movie is written by Steven Spielberg. Spoilers, but at this point, I'm getting close to the end of this marathon. Anyway, I give this episode an 8 out of 10. There's only one more episode to review, and it's the special, Wherever I Go.